Supporting. I am your girl Grace. Make sure you subscribe to this channel for future videos. How you guys doing? I hope everything is going good for you guys. All right, listen. Today I want to talk about something that ran across my desk and I found it very, very interesting. I really don't hear a lot of people talking about this, so I want to bring something to your perspective. Today I would like to introduce this topic as reborn babies. I'm not sure if you guys have heard of this before, but it's a big money maker and a lot of people are in it to cradle it. Okay. So yeah, there's this new, it's not new. Well, like I said, I just stumbled up on it, so I wanted to bring it to you guys' attention. What is a reborn baby? I mean, do you have the baby and it's reborn again? What do you guys think a reborn baby is? You know, because it's a very, very, very interesting topic. A reborn baby is basically a baby that is a doll. It's real life looking and it moves and it feels just like a real baby. But it's a manufactured baby. It's not a human to human making a real life baby. You understand? So it's just a high-end doll, basically. That's how I would kind of reference to it. But it's a big, big deal. A lot of people are heavily invested in having these reborn babies for various reasons. You know, a lot of women in today's society cannot even have kids. So I can only imagine this is something that would be almost like a replacement for them to have a child, you know, because having a kid is a lot of work. Okay, it's not just like carrying the baby, taking care of the baby. I mean, trying to get the baby in the oven. Okay, that's a lot of work on itself. A lot of women cannot conceive easily. There's so many different problems, and then when they can't have these babies as easily, then they have to turn to the doctors, and you know that's a lot of money. So now there's this replacement where the reborn babies, they are like a comforter to these moms. You know, a lot of moms have lost their babies, a lot of stillborn babies. I mean, oh my God. You know, I can only imagine to having to, you know, push out a baby that it was a stillborn, and you know, it's like, what do you say? What do you do? You know, how do you move along? How do you get over it? Because you're actually just pushing out something that's not going to be here, you know? And so this reborn baby helps cope with that. So I think that's kind of cool. You know, just like how people get pets, they may get a cat, a dog, a hamster, I don't know, a raccoon, something that's going to help them get along and get through the process. So this reborn baby, take a look at this little video just to see how they make it, and then we'll come back and talk more about it.
Bryson. Baby's name is Bryson. I make reborn dolls by using a vinyl kit that we purchase, and I paint them and I bring them to life. Reborns are a full baby, anatomically correct. You could purchase a doll at a store, but it's not going to look lifelike. So they really move and look like a real baby.
As you can see, to make it is a lot of work. It's so detailed because these babies have to look and feel like the real thing. You know, it's not like a regular doll. You'll go into the store and be like, oh, I like that doll, I'm gonna get it. This one, it takes time and it takes attention and paying attention to all the details, to the hair. They even have the magnifying pacifier, the eyeballs, the skin. They even have veins. So that's a lot of time. I wonder how much would something like this cost? It's not cheap to make. From what I researched, it's from $1,000 all the way up to $20,000. My God. So it cost damn near more to have a real baby than this one. This one costs way more than a real baby. That's kind of crazy, right? But yeah, a lot of people, they use this reborn baby. This lady, I'm going to show you a video. It was very emotional. I felt very bad for her because I can only imagine the pain and the hurt and the disappointment that she's going through as a mom who have, you know, unfortunately had a stillbirth experience. So this lady, matter of fact, just take a little look at this video about her experience and why she wants a reborn baby.
Aaliyah, so I was comfortable with them sending me a reborn that was similar to my son. There's so many emotions going through my head right now. I am so beyond grateful that I can't even put it into words.
We are so happy to be able to gift you baby Jackson. We hope you love him as much as we do. We hope he brings you some comfort and joy as you think of your dear baby Jax. With love from Aaliyah and Lorna.
His little ears. Okay, you guys are gonna see him first. You guys are gonna see him before me. Oh my God. My eyes are burning. Oh my God. It's so different seeing them in person. I saw.
Oh my God. As you can see, she had a stillborn. My goodness. So I can only imagine the pain and the hurt that will probably be there forever, you know, losing a child. I can only imagine, you know. So this is going to help her with the grieving process, you know. So I can see why she would want to have this reborn baby. But what do you think? Would you want, if you had an accident as your baby, unfortunately, if your baby was to pass away, would you want a rebirth? Would you want that? Like, how would you feel about that? I really, really want to know. Would you be okay with somebody, you know, maybe making a picture of what the baby would have looked like from sonogram pictures? How would you feel about having a reborn baby that's just going to sit there and, you know, and really not move, really not interact with you, really not grow, stay the same size forever? How do you feel about that? Personally, me, what would I want a reborn baby? I'm not sure. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not going to say yes. I'm not going to say no. I'm not sure. It depends on the circumstances, you know, because some people, the grief is so severe, like they need something there to as a replacement almost, so they don't kind of lose themselves in the whole process, you know. A lot of people who are having these reborn babies, they take them out in carriages, and you know, they're like looking like real babies. People come up to them and be like, oh, your baby's so cute, and come to find out it's not a real baby, it's just like a reborn baby. So a lot of people use them for different reasons, because losing a child, as you can only imagine, can be so devastating on the mom and the parents and the whole circle of family. So I can understand this lady. She had a stillbirth, you know, and she's just giving her experience on how it is to have the stillborn and then how it is to have the reborn baby that has really helping her, you know, because I can only imagine, as a mom myself, I can only imagine what that feels like. My God. So moving along, we're going to also talk about this other lady. She had a reborn baby as well. Her case was she couldn't have any child. She kept saying, when am I going to have a child? You know, she's praying and doing everything she can to have a child. But, you know, sometimes some women are just not meant to have kids for whatever the reason. And it's crazy. You'd be like, oh, my God, this person would make an amazing mom. And then the other person down the block that have 50-11 kids, beating them in and out of jail every 2 weeks. And, you know, the father's on crack and she's on cocaine. I mean, it'd be a mess. But the lady up the street who would make a perfect mom don't have her. You see, the womb is something else, okay? So this last video I want to show you, it's just a lady. At this point, she's collecting the reborn babies because she's not able to have kids. Just take a little look at this video, guys, and come on back.
This is Coco. She came all the way from the UK. His name is Jakari. He's my only ethnic baby. I plan to adopt more. This baby, she is my favorite baby. I know I say that about all my babies, but this baby really is my favorite baby. I have this big guy right here. This is how I would dress my real baby all the time. Like if I had a son, this is how I would dress him. When I feel lonely, I look at him a lot. If I, you know, just need comfort or something, I just go over to my crib and I pick him up and I just give him a hug, and I'm just like, okay, get through the day, let's go. It doesn't replace a child, and never will, but it does help me, especially like on my sad days where I'm just like, dang, like, why am I not a mom today, you know? And so then, you know, like I said, I just pick him up, and I'm like, it's okay, you're gonna get through this.
Oh my God, guys. As you can see, she could not have kids. I knew a young lady one time, and she had, I think, like 9 miscarriages. Yikes, right? And it was very hard for her to have kids. And up to this day, she never had a child. And you're like, do you continue trying after so many miscarriages? Because that's so much on the body. So this is just like a replacement to having a child, to feel what a child would feel like, you know, to dress him, her, put them in their little baby clothing, you know, to cuddle with them. I know that baby smell is everything, you know, so I just hope that this bring comfort to these women's lives, because everyone will not be able to have a child, you know, even if you pay tens and thousands of dollars, sometimes you're just not meant to have a child, and that's okay. There's so many different options. There's adoption. If you have the money, you can have a surrogate mom, you know, but it's because these other outlets, they're usually very costly. So of course, having a baby from the womb is the easier way to do things, but adoption can always be another way as well too. But I think I said adoption. Yeah. So, all right, guys, I just wanted to share that with you. I just thought it was so, so interesting. And it's so many women out here who can probably relate to this, who are not able to have kids, or who may have had a child and then the child may have passed away, or who may have had a stillbirth, or who may have had many miscarriages. The list goes on and on to the break of dawn, okay? So it's so many reasons why a lot of people now are investing in having a reborn baby, because their baby, unfortunately, did not make the born-in stage. So guys, I just wanted to bring that to you. It's not a long video. Subscribe to the channel. I just want to thank you guys so much, and continue to build with us over here, you know, a little community. This is our little body community. So continue to build with us over here. And I just want to thank you guys so much for coming along with me with this ride. Have a